The autonomic nervous system is a really interesting part of the brain. It's very primitive. It sits in the middle of the brain, but down low because it's so primitive. So when most people think of the brain, they think of the big cerebral hemispheres. But this is buried very low at the basis of the skull. And this started to evolve about 450 million years ago. And the reason it's so important is that this part of the nervous system literally controls all of the bodily organs. And it does so in an automatic fashion, so it's not something that you have to think about. So whoever figured out how the brain should be constructed did a great job, because it doesn't bother us with the idea, oh, I have to have my liver working now, or anything like that. It just goes about its business and regulates everything for us automatically. Fight or flight is something that a lot of people respond to, react, and actually identify it with a portion of the autonomic nervous system. So the autonomic nervous system is really divided into three sections: the sympathetic, which is known for fight or flight; the parasympathetic, which is known for rest and digest, or relax and rejuvenate; and then there's another part that is not really commonly understood or known. It's the enteric division of the autonomic nervous system, and that regulates all the functions in your gut. But for our purposes related to stress and sleep, we're really going to focus on sympathetic, which is, again, fight or flight, and parasympathetic, rest and digest, because those two regulate stress and sleep. The autonomic nervous system, abbreviated ANS, operates many, many different functions. And one of those functions is sleep. Most people think about sleep at the cortical level, and a lot of professionals definitely think that way, simply because when we go into a sleep lab, that's what we're measuring. We're literally measuring the brain frequencies, different brain waves. And as a result, when we interpret those brain waves, we say, yes, this is wake, this is light sleep, this is deep sleep, and they operate at different frequencies. But you have to ask yourself, well, what's really regulating all of this? What's controlling it? Because it's not just mankind that sleeps. If we go to primitive animals, even reptiles, they sleep too, and they don't have this part of the brain. So where does sleep really originate from? And it's at the brainstem level, particularly in the autonomic nervous system, or ANS, and within a division of that called the parasympathetic division, that's the pacemaker of sleep. And so different aspects of the parasympathetic division of the autonomic nervous system create the different stages of sleep. It was actually discovered that the ANS, the parasympathetic division of the ANS, regulates sleep by a researcher in France, and that paper was published in 2001. So that's when it first came to light that, hey, it's not the cortex in the cerebral hemispheres that regulates sleep, it's this part of the brainstem. And what this researcher and her team did was they measured sleep brainwaves the way it's traditionally measured, and at the same time, they measured heart rate variability. And what they discovered was the fact that the part of the nervous system that regulates heart rate variability also regulates sleep, because there was a synchronicity found between part of that primitive brainstem function causing heart rate variability that was very, very slow with brainwaves that were very low, producing deeper delta sleep. But the interesting part was that the heart rate variability consistent with that stage of sleep occurred 5 minutes earlier than the brainwaves. So that's how it was discovered that, no, this is the area that actually originates. And again, it was known because sleep is present in lower animals that don't have this part of the brain. One What research has determined over several decades is that the most important stage of sleep is deep sleep, also known as delta sleep or slow wave sleep. And the reason it has those names is it represents, or it's represented by, I should say, the lowest brain waves. So when the brain is most shut down at the cortical level. The reason we know it's the most important stage of sleep are several fold. Number one, if you have a sleep deprived subject and then you let them sleep, there's tremendous rebound and a lot of delta sleep comes out right away. And so we know, okay, the body definitely needs this in a big way, and there's gonna be a plethora of delta sleep, all right? The other ways we understand this to be is the association between not getting deep sleep and all the problems that ensue when you don't have it. So we know it's necessary to preserve certain functions. And when you don't have deep sleep, you end up with a lot of physical manifestations that are negative. And so deep sleep is particularly important for physical health. When you don't have deep sleep, then you end up with problems such as obesity, diabetes, heart disease, hypertension. You end up with a greater association with cancer because the immune system is not functioning as well, cardiovascular disease because of the hypertension. You even end up with a greater incidence of dementia, particularly Alzheimer's disease.